Hi students, today I will tell you about some tricks and strategies for GPAT 2018 exam. Okay, we are prepared for exam. Okay, we are ready for giving 2018 exam, but we have a doubt, that is how many questions we should attempt. Okay, so this is a common problem. Okay, so every student thinking about how many bits we should attempt in the GPAT exam. Okay, so let us see. Okay, the tricks and strategies for your GPAT 2018 exam. Right, we know there are 125 questions in the exam, GPAT exam, and one question carries 4 marks. Okay, so total 125 questions into 4 marks, the total marks are 500. Okay, so GPAT exam, okay, total marks are 500. Right, GPAT exam was started in the year of 2010. We know before 2010, okay, it was GATE pharmacy. GATE pharmacy, okay, right. So now we'll see the strategy. Okay, so strategy means the qualification marks and the All India first rank secured marks. Okay, so we'll see some strategies from past 10 years GPAT exam. Right, if we see from 2010 to 2016, okay, the first All India, okay, AIR rank. Okay, so AIR rank means All India first rank secure the marks in between 250 to 280 out of total 500 marks in GPAT. 500 marks. So what does it mean? It means in these previous six years GPAT, the All India first rank secured 50 to 55% marks out of 100 marks. 250 by 500 means 50%, no? So now you count 250 marks means how many bits we should attempt to secure to get All India first rank. Okay, here I already mentioned one question carry 4 marks. So for 250 means half of the 500. So half of 120 bits means 120, 60, 5, 2.5, 3 bits. Okay, so total 63 bits out of 125 bits. See the logic here. Okay. Okay, so if you pick the correct answer for 63 bits, okay, so you will be ranked, okay, in top 3 position, either first or second or third. Okay, only just 63 out of 123 bits. Okay, this is for top All India first rank, for top 1 to top 5th position. Okay, so I don't want to discuss about the top position. Okay, so I focus on, okay, how to qualify, how to clear GPAT 2018 exam. Okay, so what are the qualification qualification marks for GPAT 2018 expected thing? Here from past 6 years 2010 to 2016, okay, so the cutoff range is around 100 marks to 130, okay, you can consider 140 higher value. Okay, here I'm not disclose about SC, ST, OBC general. Okay, the range 100 to 140 range, forget about the reservation. So 140 is the higher cutoff limit for coming GPAT. So 140 marks out of 500 marks, no? So 140 marks, so how many bits you should opt? One bit carry 4 marks, no? So for 140, for example, if you opt 30 bits, okay, if you pick the answer for exact 30, 30 into 4 marks, you will get only 120 marks. Okay, so for, instead of 30, if you, okay, pick the questions exactly for 35, okay, 35 into 4. So how much? 35 into 4? 140 marks. Okay, so your target is for GPAT coming 2035 bits out of 125 bits. You just imagine here, just 35 out of 125 bits are there. Okay, you can leave 90 bits. Okay, no need to pick the answer for 90. Okay, so you have 3 hours time during GPAT, 3 hours time, you can refer GPAT question paper for 3 times. Okay, so for 3 times you can refer and you can pick exact 35 bits. Okay, if you pick the answers for 35 to 40, okay, so your name will be in the qualifying list. Okay, so this is the strategy. Everybody, they are preparing, continuously preparing for exam. They give GPAT exam because of not understand the pattern of GPAT exam. Many of the students were get disqualified. So along with your preparation, okay, you should understand how many bits are essential to get qualified GPAT. Okay, so 35 bits are essential. If you pick the correct one for 35 questions, it's enough. You will be in the qualification list, in the qualified list. Okay, if you opt, okay, if you pick the bubbles, exact bubble, okay, 60 to 70, your rank will be top 10, either one position or in between 1 to 10th position, okay, right. So these are the strategies, okay, but how, try to understand, here, from 4 years of our experience, 4 years of our B-Pharma knowledge, okay, if you are taking in coaching from any of the coaching institute, okay, with that knowledge concept, we can easily opt 35 to 45 bits out of 120. Okay, but students are doing mistake. Okay, for example, if a student knows exact 38 bits, okay, but he doesn't know other bits, but what he will do because of suggestion from his seniors or his from his college faculty members, okay, along with 38 bits, student may put for 30 to 40 bits. So what will happen? Okay, instead of 38, if he put 38 questions, okay, his name will be in the qualified list. But along with 38 bits, student also put the answer for remaining 38, though he doesn't know the answer for remaining 38. So because of negative marks, -0.25% negative marks, because of loss of 1 mark on each question, okay, so these impact on the presence of expected questions in the qualified marks. So due to pick the question without knowing the answer will impact on your qualifying marks, thereby the marks will decrease. So your name will be in disqualified list. So that is the reason, the best suggestion, okay, so the qualify bids for coming GPAT 2018, 35 to 45, okay, irrespective of the reservation, okay, if you pick the exact answer, if you know the exact answer, then only you pick. You have 3 hours of time, okay, utilize 3 hours of time, read question, if you know the answer also read twice, thrice, then only you pick the answer. Okay, like that, if you pick between 35 to 45, you will be easily qualify the GPAT exam. Okay, many of the students are doing mistake. Okay, if they know 40 bits, okay, they are giving some trials on rest of 40 bits. 40 plus 40 become 80 bits. Okay, instead of 40, if the student pick the exact answer for 40 question, he will be in the qualify list. But what the students will do mistake? Along with the 40 exact answer, okay, so they are giving some trials on unknown questions, okay, so because of attempting unknown questions, okay, because of wrong answer for the question, it will influence, impact on the correct answer, thereby the marks will get down, okay. For example, 40 bits, no, 14 to 4, 160 marks, okay, so if you attempt exactly 40, the candidate, the student rank will be in the qualify list. But along with 40, if the student attempt more 40 bits, what will happen? Because of many of mistake, because he doesn't know the question, answer to the question, because of many mistake, okay, it will results on 160 marks, thereby because of negative marks, okay, the marks will comes down into 120 or 150. Okay, in the coming year, if they keep the cutoff marks 130 marks, okay, he secure only 120 marks, okay, thereby he will be in disqualify list. Okay, see, 130 marks he will be in disqualify list. Instead of attempting extra 40, if the candidate attempt 40 bits only, 14 to 4, 160, but cutoff is 130, because of 160, okay, his rank will be in below 1000, all India 1000. Okay, so these are the strategies. Okay, so the final conclusion from this topic, okay, so don't excite to put more number of bits.
If you know the answer, then only pick the question. Pick the exact bubble for the corresponding question. Okay. So this is the conclusion from this topic. Okay. So try to attempt 35 to 40. Thereby you will be in the qualifying list. Okay. So don't try to attempt more question though if you don't know the answer. Okay. So try to attempt the question wherever you know the answer. Okay. So like this way, if you do, okay, you will get success in GPAT. Okay, these are the tricks and strategies to qualify in the coming GPAT. Right. Thank you very much for watching this video. Okay, do subscribe and do share with your friends for more videos. Thank you.